If your clients are always asking, hey, can I see where we're at? This is the simplest way to show them. No spreadsheets, no backend access, just a beautiful, secure client portal. I'm Phil Pallen, a brand strategist. Welcome back to my channel, where I help you build a business that looks good as well as it performs. Today's video is sponsored by Softr, and I'm so excited about this one because it's not a software review. It's actually a real world example. I am building a client portal that connects to my monday.com data without giving my clients backend access. It's branded, it's secure, and it's completely no code, which I love. Whether you run a small agency or a well-established company where partners need access to specific data, or your internal team needs a centralized knowledge base, or just a better way to keep clients in the loop, this tool is totally worth exploring. Let me show you how it works. Let's start with why I need a client portal in the first place and why tools like monday.com aren't ideal for external access. My team works in monday.com, you can see it, but I don't want clients poking around inside this. They don't need to see our tasks, internal comments, or anything that could create confusion. They just really want updates. Softr gives me the perfect front-end solution that lets me build a clean, branded interface that pulls from live data without exposing our backend. I'll show you how I did that in a moment. This is what the Softr dashboard looks like when you log in. It's intentionally simple because you're building from scratch. You'll see four main sections in the sidebar here: apps, databases, workflows, which are new, and integrations. These are really the pillar of any build in Softr. Apps are what you're creating, the front-end experiences that your clients or internal team will use. Databases are where your structured data lives, whether it's something you create inside Softr or something you connect from another platform like Google Sheets or Airtable. Workflows are where automation lives. This is exciting. This can trigger actions like sending emails, updating records, assigning tasks, or calling external APIs based on changes in your data. For example, when a new client record is added, you can auto-send a welcome email or notify your team on Slack. You can build your own from scratch or start with pre-built templates like weekly digests, onboarding flows, or alerts using AI. And integrations are how you link everything together. You can see here, I've already linked my monday.com account, which is going to come in useful. That's where all my client info is stored. And to connect this, it really only took me about a minute. Next, I'll create a new database, which is where we'll store our client project info. But I'll also show you how easy it is to pull in data from monday.com or HubSpot if you're already working in those tools. So you don't need to start from scratch. Softr makes it fast to get up and running, even if you've never built an app before. The first step is creating your app. You can start fresh or choose from over 90 templates, each one built for a real use case. That's one of Softr's biggest strengths, in my opinion. They aren't just blank canvases here. They're working layouts that you can adapt in minutes. You'll see how I do that. There are templates for CRMs, onboarding, employee training, internal dashboards, even legal case management. But for this video, I'm using the client portal template. It's designed to give your customers secure access to updates, invoices, and other key info. You can preview any template before selecting it, and once you've chosen one, the layout is easy to customize. For my portal, I'm going to tweak the structure, update the branding, and start connecting my data. I'll take a moment to get started on that now. Okay, branding updated. I'm adjusting the structure to fit my clients' needs here, and I'm connecting my data without being overwhelmed doing so. Everything you see here lives in the interface tab. See up here at the top. So this is where you design the actual user experience. For the purpose of this video, I am gonna leave some of these demo blocks in place because my client projects are confidential for the most part, but that's okay. You get to see this wonderful platform in action still. It's designed super well. You can drag in new blocks, change layouts, add logic even, personalize what each user sees based on their role. The sky is the limit here, and it's super exciting. Once you're feeling good about the interface, at least for now, we can move on to the data tab here. This is really your back end. You can use Softr databases to create and manage your structured data directly in the app, so no need to necessarily have it hosted somewhere else. Maybe users, tasks, invoices, anything like that. In my case, I've also got Monday, so it's wonderful that I can just integrate that easily. And finally, the Users tab is where you manage who gets access to what. Again, for this video, populated with example data because my client email addresses are obviously confidential, but it's super easy to imagine how you can manually add users, import them, or sync from another tool. All three tabs here work together. Once your data is connected, you can control. This layout did not take long to build and get connected. I was able to customize each section to match my exact workflow, from active projects to shared files. Every block pulls from live data and updates automatically. And I love how easy it is to jump between the interface, data, and users tabs while I'm building. It makes the whole process feel seamless. Now, let's make this portal dynamic so each client sees real-time updates without me having to lift a finger. Now, here's how I connect each block in Softr to live data from my project tracker. I want to give you a closer look at this than I did earlier. Each section of the portal pulls directly from my Monday board. You would have seen this. Or if it's not Monday, it's whichever backend I choose. Softr supports two-way sync, so changes in Monday show up here and vice versa. I added conditional visibility so clients only see the project they're assigned to, keeping everything clean and relevant. For example, notice the status of the project as complete here. But if I go into Monday and change the status of a task from complete to in progress, then you'll see that update reflected back on our portal instantly. You can also bring in documents, deadlines, status indicators, notes. Everything stays tied to your data source. It's like a live project summary that updates itself without anything manual. Let's switch perspectives now. This is what the portal looks like from your client's point of view. Check out how awesome my client dashboard is looking, not just on desktop, also on tablet and on mobile. I'm definitely going to keep customizing this further as I learn more about my clients and what they actually need. Remember, it's so easy to hop back in here and just have it evolve over time. Each client has their own secure login with permissions already set behind the scenes. You saw that earlier. Don't worry, we're going to change this image. We're going to customize it in our branding momentarily. Once a client logs in, they're greeted with a clean, branded dashboard that shows exactly what's relevant to them. View project status, check deadlines, download files, leave comments, depending on the level of access, of course, that I've assigned to them. The layout here is simple, it's intuitive, works beautifully across different devices. I can add multiple pages here. Best of all, no training is required to be able to use this thing like it would be if they were on Monday or Asana or other platforms. They just log in and they see what matters. A client portal should feel like your brand, not someone else's platform, and Softr makes that easy. This is the fun part. You saw earlier that we added my logo, but let's take it a step further. With Softr, applying your brand is simple. Colors, fonts, and logos can all be adjusted in a few clicks. The design settings are flexible, they're intuitive, so there's no need for you to code or have any clunky workarounds here. I definitely want to change that image that we saw earlier on the login page, so I will do that right now. And I've added our agency's logo. I chose a clean layout. I've styled the portal to match our website. You can even embed things like calendars, Loom videos, dashboards from other tools. The end result is gonna feel like custom software without needing the time, the cost, or the complexity that usually comes with building something like that from scratch. Okay, it's time to publish the portal, and I'm gonna show you how to give each client secure access. When everything's ready, publishing your Softr app takes just a few clicks. You can keep it on a Softr subdomain, or you can use your own custom domain for a more polished branded experience. I will hit that publish button now so you can see how fast it goes. For this demo, I added client users manually, but you can also automate invites or connect your CRM. Each client gets a secure login, which you saw earlier, with permissions already set. And best of all, when I make updates on my end, they see the latest version instantly. No follow-up emails or manual refreshes required. And that is how I use Softr to build a secure branded client portal without giving clients backend access to my tools. It's clean, it's efficient, and it makes my business look more professional while keeping everything organized behind the scenes. I've linked to Softr below so that you can try it for yourself. No code required. I'm Phil Pallen. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.